Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to add steam to a photo. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. If you'd like to use this image, I provided its link in the video's description or project files. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your brush tool and open your brush picker. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make the hardness 0% and the opacity 50%. Then press Enter or Return. Since we want to brush in the color white, we need to make the foreground color white as well. If it isn't, press D on your keyboard and then press X to invert them. To make your brush smaller or larger, press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. For this particular image, I'll increase mine to 175 pixels. However, if you're using a different image, depending on its size and resolution, you may want to adjust the amounts I'll be using throughout this tutorial. We're going to brush in a few sets of decreasingly smaller strokes. Brush up a couple of slightly wavy strokes. You can overlap them a bit if you want. Reduce the size of your brush and continue to brush up random wavy lines. When you're done, go to Filter, Other, and Maximum. I'll make the radius 30 pixels and choose Roundness. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Surface Blur. I'll make the radius 10 pixels and the threshold 25 levels. To adjust the shape of your steam, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To enlarge it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift and drag it out. Reduce its opacity to 50%. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open your Transform tool. To see the transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the Warp icon. We can distort the image by dragging the control points or a segment of the bounding box or an area within the mesh. Manipulate it to a shape you like. To accept it, click the check mark at the top or press Enter or Return. Next, we'll add vapor to the steam. To make your document fill the canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0, or to see it at 100%, press Ctrl or Command 1. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the original steam to make a selection of its shape. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Change the blend mode to overlay. Make the layer 1 copy active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the layer. Notice as soon as you made the layer mask, your colors inverted. Now, your foreground color is black. Increase the size of your brush approximately this much, and brush across the top of your steam twice. Make layer 1 active, and make a layer mask next to it. Brush over the steam again to evaporate it a little more. Lastly, let's raise the steam up a bit higher than the cup rim, which makes it look like the steam is originating from the surface of the coffee. With layer 1 still active, Shift-click on the top layer to highlight the 3 steam layers. Open your Move tool and press the up arrow key on your keyboard until you're happy with its position. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.